Today I'm going to be singing this. Yes, Joy to the World, what a great Christmas song. I'm wondering if you know who wrote the words. Well, I'm going to tell you. But I'm not going to tell you who wrote the music. I'm wondering if you know who wrote the music, and I'll read the story of the one who wrote the music after I read a little bit of the one who wrote the words. Isaac Watts. It's an old Christmas song. I'll just read you a little bit about Isaac Watts, because I'll read this again at some point, Lord willing, as I sing When I Survey the Wondrous Cross from this book. Isaac Watts, the father of English hymnody, was born in Southampton, England, the first of nine children. His father was a tailor and deacon at the Above Bar Congregational Church and was imprisoned several times for his religious beliefs. Isaac's mother, of French Huguenot descent, used to carry young Isaac to visit his father in jail. Isaac was educated at the Free School in Southampton, where he learned Greek, Latin, and Hebrew, and the Nonconformist Academy of Thomas Rowe at Stoke Newington, near London. And there's a bit more to read, but as I say, I'll save that for when I have opportunity to sing the other song that he wrote. I mean, he's wrote many songs, but that one other, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. And now, don't look ahead. See if you can guess. Oh, there's his name again. Okay. Born in, I probably moved the camera up where you could see who it was too. Also, born in Halle, Germany, George studied music at the Halle Cathedral. He began his musical career playing in the Hamburg Opera Orchestra. He went to Italy and, winning acclaim for his work, moved on to England in 1713. He enjoyed great success as an operatic composer and entrepreneur. By 1737, his luck changed and he was bankrupt. He turned to church music. It was then that he wrote his immortal Messiah. And Handel's star burned brighter than ever before. Although he became blind at the age of 67, he continued his musical performances. Before he died in 1759, George Handel created 46 operas, 32 oratorios, many cantatas, and scores of smaller works, including the music to which we sing Isaac Watts' hymn, Joy to the World, the Lord is Come. Here's either a photograph or a woodcut of one of England's oldest congregational churches, established in 1662. Oh, it's a drawing. 1716. Even though the congregational movement, the belief that each local church should govern itself, wrote its own creed and determined its own worship service, or that's what they believed, that they should write its own creed and determine its own worship service, began in England in the late 1500s. Its adherents, which numbered over 1,000 clergymen, did not separate from the Church of England until 1662, when the Act of Uniformity forced episcopal ordination and acceptance of the prayer book as a basis of worship. It was due to the Act of Uniformity and similar laws that Isaac Watts' father was jailed on several occasions for being a deacon of the above, the Bar Congregational Church. So now, something I should have sang right off the top at the beginning. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Saviour reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy. repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sin and sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessing flow, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.